I welcome you all to my lecture series, and today we are going to start Unit 5, that is Primary Manufacturing Process. And in today's lecture, we are going to know about the different kind of manufacturing processes and some glimpse about the casting process. So if you talk about the manufacturing process, it is a process that deals with the conservation of raw materials to end product or useful material, or it can be also defined as a value addition process by which raw material of low utility and value due to its inadequate material properties and poor or irregular size shape finish are converted into high utility. For an example, if you have some raw material, like you have a wooden part and you want to make something from that wood, like you want to make a chair with the help of you wood, then you need to operate, you need to do some particular operation over that wooden part, and after that you will get the final product as a chair. So all that process that is used to convert that wooden part into the chair comes into the manufacturing processes. Now the classification of manufacturing process. So actually it is very difficult to tell the exact number of various manufacturing processes till now, because nowadays due to technology and all, we are moving very fastly and we have so many manufacturing processes right now. But somehow we can differentiate our manufacturing processes into four categories. So first one is shaping and forming. In this category, we consider the shaping and forming is a part of manufacturing process. So in this part, what we do, we manufacturing a solid product of a definite size and shape from a given material. Okay, and the given material may be in form of molten material, may be in form of powder. So further on, it can be differentiated in three forms: the solid state, that is forging, rolling, extrusion, drawing. So what is this forging, rolling? We will cover in our next lectures. Now the liquid or a semi-liquid state, the casting process, we will come to know what is casting process in the next slides. And now the powder metallurgy. Powder metallurgy is also a process by which we make some solid product of definite size. Now the second manufacturing process is joining process, that is welding, brazing and soldering process. So we all have performed welding process in our workshop. So these processes are basically used for joining similar and non-similar metals. The third one is removal process, that is machining process. Consider if you have a workpiece and you want to convert that workpiece in any used form kind of tool or material. So you need to remove some excess material from that workpiece, and the process of removing can be done with the help of turning operation, drilling operation, milling operation, or non-traditional operations such as electrochemical machining, electro-discharge machining, electrochemical grinding, electron beam machining, laser beam machining, and ultrasonic machining. And the fourth one is regenerative manufacturing. Production of solid product in layer by layer. So we have the 3D printer in our department. So in that we use wire, this fused deposition modeling. This concept is used for manufacturing a solid product in a 3D printer. So this is an example of regenerative manufacturing. Now the fundamentals of casting. So basically what this casting means, we all know that casting is one of the oldest manufacturing process, and that is way before we started our civilization, and near about it is 4000 before Christ, and when copper arrowhead were made, best example of that casting process. So casting process can be understood by these lines. Casting processes basically involves the introduction of molten metal into a mold cavity, where upon solidification the metal takes the shape of the mold cavity. So what is this mold cavity, and what is this molten metal, what is this solidification, we are going to cover in our further slides. There are so many components which we use in our daily life, and that components are manufactured with the help of casting processes only. And these are the examples of some components: engine blocks, walls, pipes, statues, and so many others. So these are the components which we use, and these all are manufactured with the help of casting process. These are the engine part, the blades. Okay, so all these parts are made with the help of casting process. Since the shape is very complicated, we need some interior design also. So integrated design also. So if we try to manufacture such components with the help of machining process, it will be very difficult. That's why we use casting process for the same. Now how we manufacture component with the help of casting process. So firstly we introduce the molten metal into the mold cavity, where metal conforms the shape of cavity, right? And again, if you want to we want some integrated shape in the piece, we add that design in our the cavity, the mold cavity, internal cavities. And by using this casting process, very small and hollow parts can be produced. Now these are some important factors in casting processes. First one is solidification, and second one is molten metal into mold cavity. Third one is heat transfer during solidification and cooling of the metal in the mold. Fourth one is influence of the type of mold material. So what is solidification? When we pour the molten metal into the cavity, it starts solidify. So this phenomena is called solidification. So, and the other one is molten metal into mold cavity. If you want to make something of a particular shape, so for that, firstly we make cavity, that is mold, and then we pour the metal, molten metal, into that cavity. And this is also very important phenomena, very important operation in the casting process. Now heat transfer. So we all know that if we want to solidify a molten metal, we need to remove the energy amount of heat that mold have. So heat transfer should be good so that the metal gets solidified easily. Now the influence of type of mold material, this also depends, it also affect the quality of our product. And so this mold material have some capability to transfer heat from the mold cavity to the surrounding. So these are the operations that affect our casting process. Now these are some different kind of processes that we use and different kind of terminology that we use in casting process. Let's go through the point. The first one is components are produced by pouring molten metal into a contoured mold cavity, followed by cooling to the solid mass. So in further slides, I am going to explain this thing with the help of diagrams also. So what this means is, firstly we pour molten metal into the cavity for making the solid part. Now the cooled solid mass represent the configuration of cavity. So this is similar, we all use fridge in our home, right? We have the the ice tray. The ice tray has a shape. We have the square shape inside the ice tray, and when we pour the water inside that ice tray and we keep it into the refrigerator, after certain time we get the ice, and the shape of that ice is similar as the cavity. So same phenomena happens in casting process also. We pour molten metal into the cavity, and the final product is similar as the mold cavity shape. And the components that are produced in casting is generally termed as castings, and the cavity where we pour the molten metal is called mold, and the cooling of liquid metal to solid metal is termed as a phase transformation, and the place where this activity is carried out is referred as foundry. So this is the arrangement of basic mold cavity and the different terminology used in casting process. So let's start with mold. Mold is essential a negative of final product or having a cavity of the casting. So this is the portion that is mold. We want the final product of this shape, so this is called the mold cavity pattern. For making this cavity, we need some solid prototype and that is called pattern, and that pattern is made of wood or metal. Core is basically used as an obstruction in between the mold cavity. The whole box is called as mold box, and the upper portion of this box is called cope, and the lower portion of this box is called drag. Mold material, the material which are used for creating this mold is mold material. Many types of mold material may be used. Generally, mostly we use sand material for this making a mold cavity. Now the pouring cup. This is the pouring cup from where we pour the molten metal inside the mold cavity. Sprue is a vertical channel, okay, through which molten metal flows downwards in the mold and enters the runner. So this is a sprue. The shape of sprue is in a taper form to avoid bubble formation and air aspiration. Now what is pouring basin? This is the pouring basin. This act as a reservoir, right? fourth one is runner here. Runner channel that carries the molten metal from the sprue to the mold cavity. Gate is the portion of runner through which the molten material enters the mold cavity. So this is the gate here. Through gate, the molten material passes into the mold cavity. And the riser. The role of this riser is to provide the needed molten metal inside the mold cavity. Thus, we say it is a reservoir to supply the molten metal necessary to prevent shrinkage. Okay. So these are the steps that we follow in casting process. First one is pattern making. Firstly, we make the pattern. With the help of that pattern, we make the cavity. And sand mixing, we prepare the sand, because the sand needs some kind of property, and for keeping that property in mind in that sand, we need to mix that sand properly, and we need to add some extra materials also so that we can impart different properties that a good sand require for making a better product. Now the core making, if you want some hollow space or if you want to separate the product in two palm, then we use core there. So core making is a process involved in casting process. Melting, we use furnace to melt the metal, and then we pour that molten metal inside the mold cavity. After the solidification, we take out the product and then we do finishing, then we do testing. And for enhancing the mechanical property, we do heat treatment, and after that we do retesting. So in this diagram, we can understand the all process that we discussed in previous slide. So firstly, we have this pattern and we have this box, right? We put this pattern here. After that, we will put sand inside this pattern, process sand. Okay, we will put the sand over here. We will fill the sand. Now we will keep this box upside down, and after that we will lock this by using pin, and then we use two pins for creating the sprue. These are the pins. Then we will remove this pin. And again, we will remove the upper side of this box. And after removing this upper side of box, we will remove this pattern also. Okay. Now after removing this pattern, we can add the other box over it like this. And then we will lock it from this pin. Then the side view of this box will look like this. And since we have removed the pattern here, the cavity will be here. And now we will pour the molten metal from this side. And when the metal gets solidified, we will open this pin and we will remove the product from this cavity. So this how we perform casting operation. And in further lecture, we will come to know about the other manufacturing process. Thank you.